I just got a text about a stray dog in Chalmette over the bridge. Okay. It's a hound. Don't it look? He looks old.
Well.
One of our employees was on their way into work when they saw a stray hound mix hanging around a parking lot.
Okay, crate, blankets, leashes.
I've only been on a couple of hound rescues, and they're very difficult. They're runners a lot of the time. They're fast, and they just run and run and run.
I hope you don't run. It's too hot for all that.
My biggest concern is that we're gonna get there and he's gonna take off, or that we're gonna scare him into the very busy road.
We're getting close. Okay, so you turn right here. Pull in here. Maybe he's visiting that building. Oh, there he is, there he is, there he is. Okay. Oh, oh, sweet baby.
Out in our Assumption Parish location, we get to a lot of hounds. So the first thing come to my mind, we're gonna have to chase him.
Hey, Papa.
Earl, you see him?
He right here, laying under the tree.
Okay. Hi, baby. He looks old.
Earl and I approached slowly, but he did not seem afraid of us.
Here, Earl.
You like them?
He likes these. Oh my God, he's so cute. Earl, he loves you. You gonna make it easy?
Hi. It's an old man.
Are you an old man?
Say, he ain't crazy. He was chilling under the tree, Liz.
You made it so easy.
The fact that this guy was like so super friendly and just like, oh, hey guys, was pleasantly surprising.
I loved him.
You do?
Yeah.
Could just tell he was like a sweet, mellow guy. He just seemed like somebody's house pet.
Come on, baby. Good boy. Good boy.
We opened the van door and he just jumped right in and got in the crate and laid down. Okay, you've done this before. You've gotten into a car, you've been in a crate. It seemed to us that he did have an owner.
We're gonna scan you, bud. See if you have a...
Chippity chip, chip.
Hounds can tend to be escape artists, and so if they can find a way out of their yard, they will leave. So I think there's a good possibility that he escaped his yard or his home, and that he probably has somebody looking for him.
I love you.
Relax. No, that's how he was under the tree.
He did have some flea dermatitis on his back end and some missing hair, but all in all, he looked pretty healthy.
Let's see if you have someone.
I was hoping, because he was in pretty good shape, that he would also have a microchip.
He neutered, too.
Is he neutered? No chip. Okay.
Unfortunately, he did not have a microchip, which I was pretty disappointed in.
Let's give him a good bath. I'll give him a flea treatment. You want to have Spencer and Hooli do that? Let me go check on his kennel.
But he was neutered, so that's a good thing. Somebody got him neutered.
He's got healthy teeth. Look at his head, though. He looks like he's kind of old. It's not, like, very sunken in, but he looks like he's kind of old.
When they don't have a collar and tags on and they don't have a microchip, we look at a lot of other things before we go and we post on our website.
They're getting a side run ready for them.
Hold on, yeah, let me dry them off first.
We look at the condition that they're in. If they look like they've been well-fed and well-cared for, we look at their nails, their teeth, their body weight. He did look like he was a well-cared-for dog.
There's somebody down, huh?
So we made the decision that it would be best to post his picture on social media and see if somebody recognized him.
Come on, let's see how you like your new house.
The next step is just to wait and see if somebody comes to claim him.
Hi, Dee.
Earlier, we rescued a dog in a parking lot.
It was an old man.
told Miss T about it, so she decided to post his pictures online.
This is our ride right here, son.
Tia posted that dog on the internet, and Wade just called saying that somebody's here.
What's up?
How you doing?
You come for a dog?
We always cautious about someone coming to claim a dog. So we just trying to find a little small marking or something on the dog, and if they can't identify that, then we have doubts that's their dog.
Do you have any pictures or anything?
I've got tons of videos, pictures of them.
That's a picture of him there.
Let's see. Because I went God.
I've been looking for him forever.
Is he neutered? Is he not neutered?
Yes, ma'am. He's neutered. He's got a skin tag above his left eye. He's got an old man thing on his
skin tag.
He's missing fur on his butt.
We're good.
Got it. He knew some key things about the dog. So that's what made us really know he was the owner.
What happened?
I let him out of my house about 2 this morning and went back to sleep and woke up at 7. Open door, usually comes in. He wasn't in the yard.
Oh, wow.
Apparently, he had got a board loose. I searched the neighborhood, called animal control, and they said, no, we don't have him. And while I was on that phone call, a woman was in the office and overheard our conversation. And I guess Villalobos had just posted a Facebook post with his picture. She said, yeah, this sounds like this dog. I went and looked, and that was his picture.
It's always good, bro, to have your dog chill.
Yes.
You know, you can be the most responsible owner
in
the world.
Actually.
If we don't post it, you don't find it.
Yeah.
Do you want to grab him?
What is his name?
His real name's Scar.
Scar. And he likes his butt pat.
Oh, he loves Scar. Because he itches.
Yeah, I could do that. It's very important to chip and tag your dog. That way, if things like this happen, they always will make it back to you. Come on, Scar, baby.
Scar!
Daddy!
You can't get out, huh?
What are you doing, dude? Why'd you get out?
Oh,
yeah.
Aww. Now you're crying.
What's going
on? Oh, yeah? Talk about it.
Daddy.
Talk about it, Scott. It made me smile. So, like, that was a good reunion for him. Look, he can't
He's so
that.
Happy.
Yeah. Thank
y'all
so much.
You got lucky today, boy. You got lucky.
I was very nervous, but now I'm very happy and very relieved. Because the hardest part is just not knowing where he's at. Thank you all so much for
finding
him. For them to take the time to actually go get this dog. I'm very grateful, and I'm very, very lucky.
Bye, Scar.
If it wasn't for them, I wouldn't have Scar back. So I can't thank them enough. I really can't.